been a big week. A lot of people talking about the budget, and it's been incredibly well received. And it's always good when the people who want to throw rocks at you all the time, like the media and some of the other parties around the place, are saying that it is a good budget too. And the opposition's got nowhere to run on it. If there's one little item in the budget that probably slid under the radar that nobody thought about, it was $2 million for bariatric surgery. This is to give high needs people a stomach staggering operation to either turn off diabetes or to assist them in losing a massive amount of weight when they wouldn't be able to do it on their own. And what it will do is it'll save a lot of bed nights in hospitals, it'll save future problems with knees and hips, early death, it'll encourage and enhance people's opportunities to get back into work, and Tariana Turia, as Associate Minister of Health, made a big plug for that, and good on her. I'm very, very pleased that she's done it and very proud of her. The Whanganui District Health Board has been saying that it would cost $70 million to provide bariatric surgery for every obese person in Whanganui, and they've numbered them at 2,000. To my mind, that's a pretty ridiculous statement. But at least this budget allows for a small number of people in Whanganui to be able to get this surgery, and I'm hoping that Whanganui District Health Board will do a rethink on that. Last week I was called into the WISE class in Whanganui Intermediate. The WISE class is a group that looking at environmental issues, and they had written to me about mining in national parks. I wrote back to them and offered to come and speak, and then they gave me the invitation. And we had a wonderful debate about the prospect of mining and conservation land and the pros and cons of that. And I found that they were a pretty tough bunch to be interrogated by, and it was great that Whanganui Chronicle saw fit to document that in the newspaper. Congratulations to Whanganui Intermediate. The Armed Defenders Squad, the regional Armed Defenders Squads from Taranaki, Whanganui and Manawatu, are holding a reunion on Queen's Birthday weekend, and I'm pleased to be able to be a speaker on Saturday night along with Mayor Michael Laws, and also to be able to officiate in a church service the next morning, Sunday morning. The Armed Defenders Squad, made up of people who quite literally put their bodies on the line, have to make some very tough decisions in dealing with armed defenders in difficult circumstances, and frequently they are later pilloried by people who have got the old retroscope, which of course is 2020. Everything looks different in hindsight. So I'm looking forward to being part of that reunion over Queen's Birthday weekend. And tomorrow night in New Plymouth is the graduation of students from the Western Institute of Technology Taranaki. I'm giving the farewell speech to departing students on that night, and I'm looking forward to that. Love going to graduations and seeing young people, having completed their course of studies, head off with their bit of paper and their rite of passage into the business world. And I congratulate all those graduating students. It'll be great to be part of that too. All the best.